Building light and shade can change the focus for landscape image immensely. And Boris FX Optics has a wide number of tools to help you do this easily. In this shot, I'm going to start in the film lab category and apply a vintage color 2 strip to change the mood immediately. And I'll just find a preset. And I like how that one looks. I'm now going to build up light. So I'm adding a new layer. Come to my light category and I'll use the light filter to add a dappled gobo onto this scene. Adding displacement lets it fit more easily into the scene. I'll duplicate this layer and add it to the other side. And I'll just add a couple of variations. To place more focus on the house, let me add a spotlight. So I add a new layer and spotlight. I can move the light into place using the on-screen widget. And at these default values, the effect is a little bit too strong. So let me take the ambient value up and the brightness of the light down. Now we're going to need to balance this light with some shade. And the grads and tints category has a ton of filters to bring color into our image. But I just want the sky a little bit darker. So let's hit up an ND gradient. And I can use the on-screen controls just to move that into place as well. I can blend any layer with different blend or apply modes here. So if I try something like soft light and maybe knock the opacity back a little bit, we're getting a slightly more contrasted look. But the whole image is using the soft light blend, not just the ND gradient. So to limit it further, every layer can contain masks. I'm going to click up here, add a mask, and choose gradient mask. I'll position the gradient mask in around about the same place as I did the ND filter. So we're mainly affecting the sky. If we take a look at the before and after, we're just adding a little bit of depth to the top. Now, one of the last touches I always give is a little bit of extra color push just to tie everything together. So I'm going to head back into Film Lab. And really, some of my favorite effects are found in this category, including film stocks. There are so many presets to choose from. You can actually just click your way through until you find something you like. Now, one little trick I like to do is to swap the layer blend mode again, maybe again to something like overlay or soft light, and then knock that opacity back, maybe to about 50% to start with. And now this adds contrast and color without completely taking over the original image. And I can sort of still move through these and get a feeling of something that I want. I fancy something a little bit green and blue, so maybe I'll come back to Corpse Bride. Just to add a little bit more mood into the image. I can also exclude things with masks. So if we come up and I create a spot mask, I can position this over the building and take the feathering down a little bit. And then I can just invert it with this button up here and turn off the overlays at the top of the viewer here. Maybe add a little bit more softness. And finally, I can try to draw the eye by adding a last bit of shading. So in the color category, I can use something like haze, which is usually added to create a bit of contrast and cut through haze. But I can use this along with some masks to draw the viewer's eye. And I'll start with a path mask along the path, remembering, of course, to turn my overlays back on again. As before, I'll just invert that and add a bit of softness. I'll drag the building mask up to be able to use it again, and we can blend it together using the buttons up in the top right hand corner. This is usually easier to see if we show the mask. So let's turn the invert off and change the blending to subtract. And now we're taking out the building and the path. Now, if the shadows are getting too dark, I can mask them with a selection mask. So I can go add selection. Let's turn on the mask again. No drawings involved here. It just creates a mask based off the image. I'll keep it at luminance, but I'll make my selection position to 0, so it's just focused on the shadows, and I'm going to tweak that range up a little bit. And to see this properly, let's subtract it as we did before. Let's just take the opacity off of that layer just a little bit. As you can see, in a short amount of time, I've used light and shade to add a different flavor to this image and help to draw focus to the building. And we can even take this further if we want to. It's easy to layer effects together to enhance light and shade with Boris FX Optics. To learn more about optics, subscribe to the Boris FX YouTube channel, or head over to the Boris FX training pages at borisfx.com, where you'll also be able to download a free trial version of Optics.